Back at Credit Union Center in Saskatoon, the BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships on CBC. The ladies warming up for the free skate. Joanny Rochette's mind is racing, I'm sure. She's second after the short program. It's been a while since we've had to say that. Meantime, the former Canadian champion, Cynthia Phaneuf, leads. And could this be her resurrection after a long struggle back to prominence in the Canadian figure skating world? Well, we're by the ice at Credit Union Center, and it's a bird's eye view. Welcome back, Scott Russell, along with Tracy Wilson and Kurt Browning, for the ladies' free skate and a Canadian championship on the line. And really, it's a very interesting scenario with the four-time Canadian champion with ground to make up.
Well, she does. She's sitting in second place. She has had such a terrific international season coming into Canadians, so this is unexpected, having her in second place. However, if she has had a weakness this year in competition, it's been in the short program. And as we've seen before with Joanny Rochette, when she struggles in the short, she comes back like gangbusters in the long program.
Kurt, I know you're a fighter. You love to say that. She fought to get that jump. Do you like it when Joanny Rochette is aggressive and fights back?
I like it that she can fight back, but my wish list for her is that she doesn't have to, because internationally, and that's what we're hoping for her, is that she can go to Worlds and be super competitive and reach for that podium. She's going to need both programs. So I'm glad she can fight back, but my wish for her is that she doesn't have to.
Cynthia Phaneuf is the leader. She won as a 15-year-old in Edmonton in 2004. Is her return for real? Can it stand up?
It's looking good so far. Not perfect in the short program. She did have one major error. However, it's all about her coming back and the step that she's made. She's definitely going forward. All levels of her skating have shown an improvement. Caution you going into the free skate, she's planning 7 triple jumps. Her coach has said the goal for her is to land 4 or 5 of them. So that's what she's hoping. They want her to stick to her game plan and not get carried away with trying to win the thing. Just keep focused on the job at hand.
Quick word on Cynthia.
It's a confusing game plan for me to have. I'm going to try 7. I hope I land 4. But for my advice to her, don't get caught up in the fact that you're in first place right now. Don't get caught up in the fact that you're that close to getting to Worlds. Stick to the game plan, whatever your game plan is.
All right, looks like it's between Cynthia Phaneuf and Joanny Rochette. Canadian ladies figure skating is looking for depth across the board. With more on that prospect, here's Brenda Irving.
Well, Scott, figure skating fans are hoping the women behind me can help usher in a new era in Canadian women's figure skating. You know, it has been 20 years since a Canadian woman last stood on the world or Olympic podium. And the women have not enjoyed the same success as in the other three disciplines. But there's no easy explanation as to why that's happened. Just look at the history books. Canadian men have been world or Olympic medalists 36 times. We've done it on 20 occasions in ice dance and 33 times in pair skating. But Canadian women have managed to do it on just 16 occasions. And that's left many people scratching their heads. Former Canadian figure skater Petra Burka was one of the few Canadian women's world champions.
What we need is one role model as a female skater, and I think we have that in Joanny Rochette right now.
Good fight, triple flip, triple toe. I've been waiting for that for 2 years. Fantastic, and to come off of that mistake, fantastic.
Manon Perron is one of this country's most highly respected coaches and coach of Canadian champion Joanny Rochette. She admits finding young skaters willing to make the sacrifices necessary to be a champion are few and far between.
There's too many options, and to be successful, it's not everybody that wants to put all the effort and all their time into our sport, and to be successful, they need to do it. So I think that's the biggest problem.
Beverly Smith has covered Canadian figure skating for more than 2 decades. She says the challenges are not only mental, they're also physical.
It's been going on for a long time, and right now there are a lot of countries in the same problem. And the thing is that it's difficult for women. It's just difficult for women, period, because they grow up, they get hips, it stops the rotation. When they stop the rotation, they have to get accustomed to it all again. They lose their confidence, and sometimes it's harder to get the confidence back than the jumps.
Michael Slipchuk is the high performance director for Skate Canada. He says you can't hitch your wagon to just one star.
Cast the net wide, because at the end of the day, when we get 5-6 years down the road, you're not really sure which of those skaters are still in the sport or who's going to be at the top. And there is no perfect science to decide that at this age, and we're not about to try to do that anymore. We're going to give all those skaters every opportunity for them to show us what they're capable of doing and their motivation and drive, and just help them along the way.
And Scott, you know, another issue for Skate Canada is enrollment. It's kind of plateaued off while other sports like women's hockey, soccer have skyrocketed. And that's why Skate Canada has set up several grassroots programs to try to deal with that issue.
Thanks very much, Brenda. Here are a nice dancer and a men's figure skater to react to that. Ladies have long been at the center. Can they get back there in Canada?
Well, with all due respect to Joanie Rochette, she is back there. She is one of the top ladies in the world. And also, for the rest of the women, we are asking a lot of these kids to come out under this kind of pressure, triple jumps, to be a performer, to be an artist. Just, you know, I think it's going to take patience. And I really suggest for the parents, you know, it's not a snapshot. It's the big picture, and there are many, many paths to the top. Don't give up when the times get tough, because they get tough. And I say you want the tough times early on so you can really grow.
Really quickly, take a page out of the Americans' notebook. Whether they're good or not, they stand at center ice and they think they are. They got to think that way.
All right. So patience. You talked about patience. The country can be patient, the parents can be patient, but the skaters who go today in the free skate cannot be patient. Here are the standings after the short program. Cynthia Phaneuf has the lead. She is a former Canadian champion. Her lead is less than 2 points over Joanie Rochette, the four-time Canadian champion. And Mira Leung skates way back. You know what? Mira Leung has to get back in the picture, because she's three times the Canadian runner-up.
Representing British Columbia and Yukon Territory, please welcome Mira Leung.
Here's 19-year-old Mira Leung of Vancouver with a job to do, and I'm sure she's going to set her jaw and take a crack at it. Three times she has been the runner-up at the Canadian Championships. This tends to be where she rises to the occasion.
Skating to Rachmaninoff's Piano Concertos number 2 and 3. She is hoping for a good skate here, because so far this season has been a difficult one for her, finishing 7th and 11th on the Grand Prix circuit. Opening here with a triple Lutz. Triple Lutz, double loop. Nice start.
See if she can follow up what was a big triple Lutz for her. Important jump in her program, triple flip. She is getting air today.
One of her most difficult jumps is a double. It's the double axel. Doesn't get as much height on that jump. It's a different forward entry takeoff.
Lofty ambitions to get to the Olympic Games in her hometown of Vancouver. She has Olympic experience. She competed in Torino at the Palavela, where she was 12th.
location planned here. Worked very hard at her artistry, working on her line and her flow across the ice. It's always her jumps that make or breaks her performance. When she nails them, she rises in the standings, and as you can see here today, she's struggling on her jumps again, and she just doesn't get enough out of her other elements to hold her up. But just not the energy and the excitement we're used to seeing Mira Leung create at center stage.
Mira Leung, sixth after the short program, and she has a ways to go at the BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championships in Saskatoon. Welcome back to Credit Union Center in Saskatoon. Mira Leung of Vancouver awaiting her marks as we revisit that free skate at center ice.
Mira likes to use her toe pick to get into the air. They're better than her edge jumps. You're looking at a big version of her triple lutz. She started this program off very strong, and then it kind of got away from her.
Yeah, even the first two jumps were quite good. This was her second one, her triple flip. But you're right, Kurt, she started to have trouble on her jumps, and it took it out of the performance for her. There's a triple flip that was later in the program. Not only did she fall, it was under-rotated, so she didn't even get credit for trying the triple flip. She was downgraded on a double axle. Her jumping problems kind of fed into the rest of the program and took out her energy and her sparkle and her speed.
Technical elements, 40-47, 42-20 for the program. There is one deduction, 81-67. Her free skate score, her total will be 130-43, and that leaves Mira Leung in second position. The ice surface at Credit Union Center, and all alone out there now, a young skater, 18-year-old Diane Smith, born in Watford, Ontario, population 1,700. She now trains in Strathroy with Scott Raychuk and Allison Perkis. Fourth after the short program, and about 4 points back.
This is a skater who's been tearing it up on the junior circuit internationally, finishing third in the Junior Grand Prix in France, and second in South Africa. She made it to the Junior Grand Prix final, opening here with her triple toe. One of the reasons for her success internationally has been this next jump coming up, triple lutz in combination. Not today.
You know, when the timing is off and you put in that toe pick, it sometimes feels like it went into cement instead of ice. She's got to get back into it. Good focus, good training.
Diane's a busy person on and off the ice. Pre-medical student at the University of Western Ontario in London.
Thank you. This next jump is key for her. It's a triple flip, a difficult jump. Not only is she fighting for a spot on the podium, fourth after the short program, she's also looking to earn a trip to Junior Worlds. Good for her. Again, you talked about her training, and that's showing really good fight and determination.
Yeah, you have to be smart and smart on your skates, shall we say. She gave up a chance for a combination by missing the lutz earlier in the program and had the composure enough to add it after the triple toe. This is a great piece of music. There's a lot of intrigue in the guitar work. She could challenge herself to try to come up to this level of music. But I think on the Canadian national stage, sometimes you're just trying to survive out there. And she's looking good.
Kurt, you talked about wanting to see our women look like they want to be out there and demand everybody's attention. She's finished her jumps, and now's the time where she has to sell the program. Take the risk, put yourself out there.
And people at home might be saying, well, how do you do that? Well, it's in your face, it's in your attitude. It's showing that each move is important to you.
And you're constantly changing your focus within a routine. You draw it in as you focus for the jumps, and then you have to go back out to the audience and remember to entertain. It's that combination that is so elusive.
So she's got the training. We need the salesmanship now.
Scott Rachek, Allison Perkis, her coaches, a substantial and appreciative crowd in Saskatoon. Diane Smith of Strathroy, Ontario. The road back. Welcome back. Diane Smith waiting with her coaches Allison Perkis and Scott Rachek, and everybody's having a little laugh. Let's take a look at her program.
There's the opening lutz. She did not get a good takeoff, and as you said, you pick in and it feels like you're hitting cement. You get no lift in the air, so you can't do your rotation. Here's where she was thinking on her feet, though, later in the program.
Yeah, just a planned double, triple toe, but she was smart enough to think, I left out some points by not being able to get that triple lutz in. And you know what? These guys are, is that a marriage proposal, a trophy? Does she get to pick? I mean,
I don't know, but Diane's got her name tattooed on their hearts and on their bellies. They're from her hometown of Watford, Ontario, not far from London.
That's fun. 83.85.
And here are the results for Diane Smith in the free skate in Saskatoon. Technical elements, 43.12, 41.73 for the program with the deduction, 83.85 for the free skate. And in the short program, 135.84 to take the lead, the 18-year-old junior eligible skater Diane Smith.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing Quebec, please welcome Amélie.
Current standings, Diane Smith has the lead. And on the ice now is Amélie Lacoste, a 20-year-old from Saint-Hubert. That's her training site at the Gaétan Boucher Arena. And Amélie is on her way back.
And maybe taking a few seconds here to kind of calm down from the cheerleading squad that was at the end of the rink. That could be distracting.
She has been plagued by injuries over the last four or five seasons. This year, she suffered an illness, flu-like symptoms, which ended up, they discovered she was anemic. She says since the beginning of December, she's felt her energy back, feeling like herself again. And in the short program, she skated like she'd been given the gift of health and is in a virtual tie with Joanny Rochette. Opening here with her triple loop.
Lost momentum on the last jump of that combination, the double loop. Not a huge mistake as long as it doesn't affect her mentally. I think we just got our answer there.
She does not have a Lutz planned, did not attempt a triple flip. Really, she has to be able to nail everything from here on in if she's to have any chance to stay on the podium.
Tracy, you mentioned in a virtual tie with Joanny Rochette, the four-time Canadian champion. Emily is only 3/100ths back of Joanny after the short program.
Going through a skater's mind when they're in a situation for one of the first times in their lives. So the hopes, the expectations, all the work that went into it. And when you feel that starting to slip away, the concentration is so hard to pull back.
She has a planned triple coming up here. Her very best jumps, triple loop.
Adding a double on the end of it. She had an opportunity early in the program to do the triple loop, decided to do double loop. By doing the loop later in the program, you get rewarded with extra marks, adding a sow cow, and are we seeing a comeback?
Great potential earlier in her career. She was the 2005 Canadian Junior Champion.
In the women's free skate, you're allowed 7 opportunities for jumps. In the short program, only 3. She took full advantage in the short program and capitalized on that by having very strong triple loop. In the free skate, though, she doesn't have the repertoire of triple jumps to fill the boxes with triple jumps.
With high scoring jumps, yeah. So she can't afford mistakes.
So much on the line. All of these women trying to earn a spot to Four Continents in Vancouver in February at the Olympic venue and maybe to the World Championships. She's come a long way back, Emily Lacoste, who was 8th at last year's national championships, puts it together in the free skate here in Saskatoon. One more look at the program of Emily Lacoste.
So she actually had three, maybe four triples planned in this program. She executed three triple jumps. This one, she was leaving to see how she felt. It was maybe going to be a double flip, maybe going to be a triple. In actual fact, it turned out to be a single flip. So of her seven jump opportunities, she had three or four planned. Joanie Rochette has seven triples planned, and that's kind of the difference. And so for Emily Lacoste, while she's sitting in third place, she still is, Kurt, making a comeback and still not fully recovered and doesn't have all of her jumps.
Yeah, I think the point you made during her program that she just doesn't have, you know, enough cutlery to fill the drawer, shall we say. It's just not enough. And interesting, not even a triple toe.
Big smile on her face. No deduction there. 89-46. 143-01 for Emily Lacoste. Thumbs up. She's in first place right now. Two skaters to come.
So she can finish no lower than third. What a huge accomplishment by fighting back, Kurt.
And fantastic spins. I think we forgot to mention the spins. She got full levels on her spins. And, you know, we get caught up in the jump sometimes. We have to always remember that it takes everything. And now, another moment of truth for our champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next competitor, Representant Quebec, please welcome Joanie Rochette.
Let's go.
Joanie Rochette. Final slap of the hands from her coach, Manon Perron. Four times the Canadian champion. Finished fifth at the Olympic Games. She's been fifth at the World Championships. This was to be the breakthrough season. This is a big moment.
Thank you.
4 short minutes, but they speak volumes about what a great champion has to offer. The drive for 5 is alive. Welcome back to CBC Sports Weekend. Scott Russell with Kurt Browning, Tracy Wilson, Brenda Irving. There's Joanie Rochette, the four-time Canadian champion, waiting for her marks, and out on the ice, all alone right now, is Cynthia Phaneuf, the leader after the short program, and she's got a challenge ahead of her.
Well, if the first jump told the story, it said, I'm on, I'm perfect.
You know, 60 seconds into the program, the word light came into my mind. Very light, shoulders down, relaxed. Fantastic program designed to take advantage of changes of music in the flying spin, in the spiral sequence, in the landing of the first triple loop. Absolutely unbelievable. And when those moments happen, the momentum just gets building, and somewhere in the spiral sequence you could feel this audience go, yeah, this is special.
And you could see her coach going, yeah, throughout the program. Manon Perron, that truly is a team effort. Choreographed by Lori Nickel, wonderful choreography.
The line on Joanie Rochette. Technical elements.
Her best score this year, 124 internationally. Look at this.
131.77, way up there for Joanie Rochette, the four-time Canadian champion, who has thrown down the gauntlet to any who would challenge that national title in this such an important year in the lead up to the Olympic Games. And that challenger is Cynthia Phaneuf, who turned 21 years of age yesterday. That's her coach, Annie Barabay.
Cynthia, who had to skate around and watch a standing ovation and miss all the stuffed animals. She had to focus on that distracting moment, but you could tell that she was smiling for her friend. But you know, she has to make this moment about her now. Take that momentum and make it a positive thing. I know a lot of skaters who love to skate after a standing ovation.
Yeah, it gets the energy in the audience. And remember, her game plan is to try and land 5 triple jumps. And I think one of the reasons the coaches decided to set that as her goal was if Joanie did skate perfect, then it would be a real tough battle for Cynthia. Now, she owns her destiny.
Joanie Rochette after the short program. She won the national title at age 15 in 2004 in Edmonton.
Up next, her most difficult triple. It's a triple Lutz.
With the problem on the Lutz that we just saw, it kind of switches gears immediately to world team, and she's now fighting for second.
Audience groaned. Cynthia was able to get up and look her coach Annie Barabay in the eye, smile. coming up, Triple Salchow.
The audience, fantastic, rewarding her efforts, applauding her on. That's just what she needs. She's got enough left in this program to get her where she wants to be.
Spots for Canadian women available at the World Championships in Los Angeles in March. Cynthia Phaneuf wants one of them dearly.
And I think that triple Lutz just gave it to her.
Opening jump in this program, the triple toe, the best one I've seen from any of the women all week. Here's another one. Welcome to the world team.
You know what they say, growing up is hard to do. She won the Canadian championship as a little wee 15-year-old in 2004. She's now become statuesque, a beautiful figure skater. And maybe, just maybe, a spot for Canada at the World Championships.
Well, for Cynthia, it's always been about the performance, the artistry, the music, and that's why she's so endearing to an audience. As she fell, she took the wind out of the sails of everybody in the audience, too. You could just feel and hear collectively the groan and the gasping, but they also willed her on, and it was just because she reached out to the audience with her performance, never lost sight of the music or them.
I don't think 3 years ago, after not only one fall but two hard falls back to back, to get up and do what she did in the second half of this program, accolades. I was really impressed, and her face is so easy to see, her emotions. She's got the kind of face you can see from 30 rows up, and the expression gets over the boards, and I think that's what we're talking about, people connected with her.
And it looked like her strategy paid off, Kirk, because had she gone for broke and tried to do everything, you make one mistake and then you let down because you were less than perfect, and you start to kind of set up the disappointment in your program, as opposed to I can still do it, I can still reach my goal. Opening with a triple toe, then she went into this, her first triple Lutz. Toe pick slipped on the takeoff, so she didn't get up in the air.
Similar to the short, yes.
Now let's take a look at her second triple Lutz late in the program. Extra 10% for this. After a number of falls, she was not going down.
No, and you know what I was thinking? I was thinking defensive. I was going, change it to Salchow, change it to Salchow. And you know what? She didn't need to. And this was in addition. That was not on the jump sheet.
Little exclamation mark there. She really knew she had done something very, very good here at the Credit Union Center in Saskatoon. Celebrated her 21st birthday just yesterday here in Saskatchewan. Born in Sorel, Quebec, trains out of Contrecoeur with Annie Barabay and Sophie Richard. There's Joanne Rochette, who has delivered a wonderful free skate here at the Canadian Championships and seems destined for her fifth national title. Five golden rings for Joanny Rochette.
Well, she was able to land five triple jumps, and that was a mission accomplished for Cynthia Phaneuf. A couple of the misses, the lutz and the flip, well, she won't get even credit for trying those. They were not fully rotated as she went down.
So reality sets in after the emotion, and we realized that there was three falls mixed up in there. And so what, you're making me nervous?
Oh, no, no. There's still work to do. I mean, a big step forward, still more.
The other person in the mix is Amélie Lacoste, who is currently in second spot behind Joanny Rochette. And really, we're talking about three people who will be looked at for four continents in Vancouver at that Olympic rink, the Olympic test event.
That's true. The world team is not just strictly chosen, you're right, by what happens here tonight.
Yeah, but this went a long way, this performance, to show she can handle some pressure.
96-26 in the free skate for Cynthia Phaneuf. 151-42, and that'll do it. That's where she wants to be. She moves up from her position at the last Canadian Championships, and she winds up second. Right now, let's go down to Brenda Irving.
Well, Joanny Rochette with tears of joy after that free skate. Am I correct in saying that it was something that was very important tonight for you to prove to yourself out there on the ice?
Yes, of course, after the short program, I was a bit angry at myself, but I knew that I had to do this kind of long program to finish my week on a good note.
What do you take away from this week? What did you learn about yourself, about your skating, about, I guess, your resilience?
Well, I think that I'm much stronger mentally than I thought I was. I think I put myself in a very tough situation after the short program. I was very disappointed of my personal performance. So to come back out there tonight and just do it for myself like I was trained to do, I'm very happy about that.
Four continents, just a couple of weeks away now. Any changes that you think you'll want to make between now and then?
I can't talk at this point. I just finished the competition, so for now we're going to celebrate the victory, but after we'll go home and think of this when my head is clear.
The goal this year was stated to be on that world podium. Do you think you're on track?
I definitely think my long program's on track, but I know I need to make my short program stronger, so we'll work on that.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Joanny Rochette, five-time Canadian women's champion.
Joanny Rochette rockets to the victory, a resounding win for the champ, an encouraging result for the runners-up, Phaneuf and Amélie Lacoste. Quebec skaters strong in Saskatoon. Amélie Lacoste climbs onto the podium for the first time. Cynthia Phaneuf, sterling silver, and for the fifth time, Joanny Rochette reigns supreme center ice at the national summit. Mission accomplished for Joanny Rochette. A fifth national title is in the bank, along with her coach Manon Ferrand. Absolutely brilliant in the free skate at Saskatoon. And an inspired performance by former national champion Cynthia Phaneuf, who wins the silver medal. Let's join Brenda Irving.
Well, Scott, as you can see, I am with Cynthia Phaneuf, and you know your coach Annie Barabé said before you headed out in the free skate, her goal for you was just to come off the ice with a smile on your face. So I guess it was mission accomplished.
Yes, it is. I was very proud of myself because I turned all of my jumps and I fight until the end. It was a very difficult program for me because I fall very hard on two jumps. So I just had to keep the focus until the end, and that was very difficult for me. And to skate after Joanny too, that was very tough.
What does a performance, not only in the free skate but in the short program, what does all of this do for your confidence?
You know what, because I was feeling so well on my short, I didn't know how to feel in my long program, so for me it was easier.
You were 21 years old, you turned 21 yesterday, you were in bed by 9 o'clock, so what sort of celebration do you have in store for yourself tonight?
You know what, I don't think it's going to be tonight because I'm very tired, but it's going to be at home with my family when I come back.
Well, congratulations on a great result, and looking forward to seeing you in a couple of weeks' time at the Four Continents competition.
Thank you very much.
Now let's head back to Scott.
Thank you, Brenda, and thank you, Cynthia. And at the outset, we talked in terms of ladies' figure skating, Kurt, especially you, about owning the ice when you step on. They certainly owned all of our attention in that free skate.
Well, there were certain moments in the last two skaters' programs where the audience just whoosh, you know, came right behind the skater with all this momentum and all this support. And the fact that Cynthia did take those two hard falls, that's tough. And then she didn't give up.
I think it was a telling sign. After one of her hardest falls, she got up, she was right in front of the judges, and literally the audience just went, ugh, as she fell. She picked herself up, she looked at her coaches, and gave them a big smile. And when a skater does that, they instantly relax. She was able to make eye contact, have a little fun, settle in, and go on and do the next jump. I think that's very, very important. A great lesson.
What do you make of the performance of Joanie Rochette? It is becoming a bit of a pattern that she has trouble in the free skate, but comes back so strong in the long program. What do you make of that, Kurt?
Well, it is a troublesome pattern, but at least there's growth. I mean, Joanie is definitely handling everything better, and I mean even the interviews and even the practices and all those things that you guys don't get to see at home. You see the competition and you see the result, but we're here all week. This girl is growing. So this short program, like, her problems are getting less and less, and now she's just got one problem to fix.
And she knows it.
It's a short program.
So she's not denying that there's an issue, and that's what I like to hear, because how can you solve a problem if you don't own that you have the problem? Cool. This is not a fluke, and that's what she's saying. This is something that has to be addressed. And also, kudos to her coach, Manon Perron. If anybody can help her to find that magic in the short program, it's Manon. She's superb.
All right, anyway, you wrap it up. Joanie Rochette is the national champion for the fifth time, and Cynthia Phaneuf, the silver medalist. By the way, Emily Lacoste, also of Quebec, wound up with the bronze. When we return to Saskatoon, we'll crown a new pairs champion at the BMO Canadian Figure Skating Championship.